audiobook titled The Vegetarian Life, A Way for You to Help Save Humanity, written by Owen Jones, narrated by Subhash Chander, publisher Tektime. Preface. Hello and thank you for buying this audiobook called The Vegetarian Life. Vegetarianism has been a culinary philosophy for thousands of years, but not so much in the West until it started to make a comeback in the early 20th century. It was taken on board by the hippie movement in the 60s and 70s because any of them drew inspiration from the East and in particular Buddhism. The children of those hippies often continued the lifestyle imbued in them by their parents and have now passed it on to their own children. Nowadays, very few towns, no matter how small, are without a vegetarian restaurant. This is not a recipe book, although it does discuss vegetarian food and does give a few example recipes. It is really for those who want to know more about vegetarianism, perhaps in order to better understand the movement or their vegetarian friends and family members. I hope that you will find the information helpful, useful, and profitable. The information in this audiobook on vegetarianism and related subjects is organized into 16 chapters of about 500 to 600 words each. As an added bonus, I am granting you permission to use the content on your own website or in your own blogs and newsletter, although it is better if you rewrite them in your own words first. If you have any feedback, please leave it with the company you bought this audiobook from. Thanks again for purchasing this audiobook. Regards, Owen Jones. Table of Contents. Chapter 1. Being a Vegetarian. Pros and Cons. Chapter 2. Adding Variety and Vitality to Your Vegetarian Meal. Chapter 3. How to Be a Good Vegetarian House Guest. Chapter 4. How to Cook for a Vegetarian Visitor. Chapter 5. How to Make Vegetarian Soup. Chapter 6. Three Delicious Vegetarian Main Courses. Chapter 7. How to Make a Vegetarian Pizza from Scratch. Chapter 8. Is It Okay to Be an Expectant Vegetarian Mother? Chapter 9. Tips for Feeding Your Vegetarian Baby. Chapter 10. The Social Vegetarian. Chapter 11. Vegetarian Diets for Your Cat and Dog. Chapter 12. Your Vegetarian Baby. Chapter 13. The Rules for Being a Vegetarian. Chapter 14. Vegetarianism on a Budget. Chapter 15. The Vegetarian Life. Chapter 16. Weight Loss, Health, and the Planet. Chapter 1. Being a Vegetarian. Pros and Cons. If you're considering becoming a vegetarian, then you must be asking yourself about the pros and cons of doing so. There are different ways of looking at this. On the macro or global scale, you as an individual, by giving up eating meat, will personally save the lives and sufferings of all the animals that you would have consumed if you had not given up. On the other hand, a few hundred animals over quite a few years will not make much difference to the animal population. What is more, with the Chinese and Indian populations becoming richer, it is almost certain that they will be eating more and more meat in the near future. You will be doing your piece though. However, on the micro, on personal level, becoming a vegetarian will alter your life. Those who have faith in detox diets say that lots of toxins that they say mount up in our bodies come from the hormones, pesticides and antibiotics that are in meat but ought not to be. Meat, eggs and dairy products are a Westerner's foremost source of cholesterol and fat, but cholesterol and fat are blamed for being the main contributor to the West's biggest killer, heart disease. It is a fact that there are other reasons for heart disease, yet it has been estimated that vegetarians have about a quarter of their meat-eating compatriots' chances of having a heart attack. This seems noteworthy, but the difference between vegans and meat-eaters is even more stark at one-tenth the likelihood. So it seems to matter what form of vegetarian you become, because lots of vegetarians still eat fish, eggs and cheese and drink milk. However, by giving up meat alone, you will miss out on lots of chemicals that farmers force into their meat and poultry. For instance, preservatives are reckoned to be connected to some cancers. Growth hormones given to animals have an effect on our own hormones, and many people just cannot digest milk, which causes the production of mucus and can give rise to digestive problems. On the negative side, you will need to learn a whole new system of supplying your body with the nutrients and vitamins that it requires. Meat is a concentrated kind of food, so only eating a standard Western meat and two vegetable type meal without the meat will soon become boring and land you in very hot water. Malnutrition is the biggest risk that novice vegetarians have to be cautious of. Naturally, it is not so difficult to get hold of knowledge to help you make your vegetarian diet right as it is used to be, and there is a vast choice of foodstuffs on hand for the contemporary vegetarian, but they are not.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.